Hey everybody, today we're going to be doing a video, Top 10 Reasons I'm a Christian. I used to be an atheist. Thank God I left the madness of atheism. So let's start off with Top 10 Reasons I'm a Christian. And we may go over 10, you know. I wonder why this person's just sitting there. Oh, they broke down. Okay, top 10 reasons I'm a Christian. Number one, the evidence. I left atheism because there is no proof and evidence that atheism is accurate and correct. We know Jesus Christ is a real historic person. Another reason are the teachings of Jesus Christ. You can tell their truth. Another reason, and they're awesome also. Another reason, and it has to kind of tie into where the evidence for God's existence and the evidence for Jesus Christ being God in the tempted flesh of man. But the main reason I'm a Christian is because it's truth. I do not see anything in science that contradicts Christianity. I do not see anything, in the natural world that contradicts Christianity. I do not see anything in creation that contradicts Christianity. I go to creation.com and you will see what I'm talking about. DNA is another reason why I do believe in God. I do believe that Jesus Christ is God, and I do believe that DNA is proof and evidence of intelligent design. You know, DNA is a language. Another reason why I believe in Jesus Christ are the moral teachings of Jesus Christ. They match up with the way that I feel spiritually. For example, I know that murder is wrong, objectively. And when I was an atheist, murder was not wrong, objectively. It was just wrong for some people, and other people it's okay, you know. And I just couldn't live with myself as an atheist with that worldview, because it doesn't really match up with reality. We all know that murder and rape are wrong. So the moral realm also is why I chose Christianity. If you believe that rape is objectively wrong and murder is objectively wrong, and everyone does, well, Christianity matches up with what we know in morality, that these things are wrong. I do not believe, like how the atheists believe, that we're all just animals and we're controlled by chemical reactions in our body, because I know if I want to move to the left side of this lane, I can choose to, like thus and so. If I want to move to the right side of the lane, I can choose to, like thus and so. So we have choice. We have a mind. We have a mind that allows us to make decisions of, should I do this or should I do that? And then I also am a Christian because of what we see in the universe. The universe is extremely complex, yet it is predictable. There is design in the universe. There's not just randomness, there is design. You can predict things in the universe. Boy, it just got really cold through here too. I thought it was going to be. It got really chilly through here. And for California, that's saying something. So, now, another reason why I'm a Christian, we have to talk about Jesus Christ. The teachings of Jesus Christ are phenomenal. They do not match up with the teachings of man. And if you read the teachings of Jesus Christ, they're out of this world. Why the world says, go for the gusto, get all you can. You have a person in Jesus Christ, God, in the tently flesh of man, that is saying, love those that hate you, pray for your enemies. I mean, this is totally opposite of what the world teaches. This is a teaching out of the world, out of this world. You have the teaching where he says, look, if someone asks for your cloak, you know, if someone asks for something, you give them more than even what they ask for. So I find the teachings of Jesus Christ very compelling. Now, I like to strive for perfection. Why is it that we have this feeling where we want to do the best that we can? And we have a plumb line, so to speak, where there's perfection, there's perfect good, and then there's evil. And we're always comparing things to what is good and what is evil. And where does this standard come from? I believe that it comes from God. And so I want to be perfect, but I'm a sinner. But through Jesus Christ, I am perfected. You actually are inheriting this righteousness when you become a Christian. You're adopted into God's family. Science is on the side of Christianity. We know that the universe is not eternal. Something created it. The problem is, like, for example, this motorcycle can't create itself. It needs an outside source. One of the problems that scientists have, not all scientists, some scientists just admit it. They say that God created the universe. The secular scientists don't want to go there. They'll say, well, I don't know what created the universe. So we have the morality is why I chose Christianity. The main reason, though, is because it's truth. I haven't seen anything in reality, anything in science, anything in the natural world that contradicts Christianity. I haven't seen anything. The world, imagine the world like a puzzle. And as you try to piece the world together and try to understand it, nothing fits, nothing makes sense until you put the piece of the puzzle in, that is the teachings of Christianity, the teachings of Christ. Then it makes sense. You realize everything is for God's glory. The universe is for God's glory. You and I, we're here to glorify God. Heaven is to glorify God. Everything is for the glory of God. Everything makes sense when you look at it in that light. When I was an atheist, and then next we'll talk about why atheism doesn't make sense, and I know I'm probably going over 10 reasons already for Christianity. But when I was an atheist, there wasn't really a lot of love in atheism, but you see the love in Christianity. You see it. You see the tolerance, you know, and tolerance is not acceptance. You know, like we tolerate things in the world that are not really good, but we don't accept them. You know, we're able to tolerate but not accept. And we all know that unless God steps in, the universe eventually is going to die and everyone within it will die. There will be no escape. Yet you have people like Stephen Hawking, who's an atheist, and he is saying that, well, we got to hurry and we got to go colonize the universe. But Stephen Hawking must have forgot, you know, because, you know, he is an educated man, but there's a lot of educated idiots. I'm not saying he's one of them, but he must have missed the fact that the universe is not going to last forever, and all of humanity is going to die under the atheist worldview. I'm not talking about my Christian worldview or your Christian worldview that says we're going to have a new heaven and a new earth. On atheism, everything dies in the end. All of humanity dies on atheism because science has proven that the universe is winding down is not lasting forever, and Christianity has a solution for that. We know that God's going to create a new heaven and a new earth. Atheism has no solution. So on atheism, when atheists say, oh, well, we're doing everything we can to perpetuate the species. No, they're not, because try as much as you like, try as hard as you can. On the atheist worldview, everything dies. It dies a stinking, rotting, purposeless death. So on atheism, everything is really purposeless. There's no purpose to it. You're not glorifying God, so you can't say you have this objective purpose. What is the purpose of atheism? Many atheists will be honest and say there is no purpose. Eat, drink, and then we die. That's the purpose of atheism. So now let's talk about evolution. This is another reason why atheism doesn't make sense. All evolution is a theory on how things, listen guys, change over time. How things, what? How they change over time. Evolution is not, nor has it ever been, a theory on how things got here. Evolution doesn't talk about how things got here. It just talks about how things change over time. Another reason why atheists just don't make sense on a lot of things that they say is they'll say God doesn't exist because everyone is saying there's a bunch of different gods. For example, they'll say the Muslims say that the Muslim God exists, and the Jews say that the Jewish God exists. The Christians say that the Christian God exists. Therefore, they'll say no God exists. But that's just not rational. It's not rational at all, because because everyone's saying God exists and we have a difference of opinion on the nature of God, that wouldn't have us think that, oh, God doesn't exist. We would think, okay, God exists, but there's a difference of opinion on the nature of God. So I don't get that. I don't get why atheists will say that, you know, that because everyone's saying there's a bunch of different gods, therefore God doesn't exist. If anything, as I've used this analogy before, if anything, that would make you think that God does exist. If everyone's saying God exists, and we admit that we have a disagreement on, I see a motorcycle up here, but we have a disagreement on the nature of God, we wouldn't say, therefore God doesn't exist. We would say, okay, we all agree God exists, but someone's got to be wrong on the nature of God. So atheists say God doesn't exist because there's a disagreement on the nature of God or which God exists. That just doesn't make sense. Hold on. Let's go around this corner. Hold on. Oh, another thing too is another reason why atheism doesn't make sense is atheists will say, who created God? Who created God, they'll say, right? Let's go this way so we get in front of this. They'll say, who created God? Well, no Christian believes in a created God. This guy's freezing like me. I gotta go right here. In fact, it's sinful to believe in created gods. So I don't get why atheists think it's some brilliant response to say, well, who created God? No Christian believes in a created God. So I don't get that.